Alrighty, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the summer update for Pet Simulator 99. Hopefully everyone is having a good day. If you're having a good day, please subscribe and like the video if you haven't already. We are on the road to 400 subscribers, and I'd be very much appreciated if you do hit that subscribe button, as literally I think 99% of people are either subscribed and 1% are subscribed. So please check that you are subscribed and hit the button. Please. Thanks. Anyway, so today's video, I am currently hatching some eggs for probably the last time in this area before going over to the spawn and going to the summer event, which I don't know how it's going to work here in the void, but I know how it's going to work in tech world, so I might have to go in the tech world and see how it works. But of course, we've got all else I'll have to leave them behind, as apparently the event is similar to like the backrooms, where you can't AFK in the area overnight or anything, because you'd be teleported back to the spawn. But I suppose time will tell. And and also I was looking at my video feedback recently. It was like the video that I wanted to hit 20 likes, and you guys are doing pretty good with the video at the moment. It's currently got 13 likes, and we've got 7 more until the huge robber pug will be officially given away, and you guys will have one day to submit your Roblox username for that giveaway when we do hit that goal. So yeah, and in terms of the deadline for that, let's say June 5th, if we hit 20 likes on that video, then I'll give away the huge robber pug, and then the 6th of June we'll be giving that away if there is any more than 3 entries, as I do want to make it fair. In between videos, which the last video was May 31st, which was 2 days ago, I did actually end up getting a couple more huge pets. Bought some, had some, sold some, and there they are. I hatched a rainbow huge bee, and I also hatched another prison cat by the name of Jim. And why did I name him Jim? Good question. It's just because, well, we're following the queso theme for the prison cats, because queso keeps imprisoning his employees, and why not? And yeah, the update is now out, so I'm going to be... Alrighty, ladies and gentlemen, we're back. And we're not getting a new event world, we're actually getting a full-blown new world with the name of Obby World. And we've got the patch notes here, so we'll go ahead and show them off right now. So we've got 5 new islands that you can show up, that you can see. It's kind of mini islands scattered across the world. Find upgrades, relics, rewards, even eggs with increased huge chances. This guide is similar to the Backrooms event, so don't expect much. So, and also it's really, really big. I don't know how hard the parkour is going to be, because we haven't checked that out yet. 4 new pets, and we got a Sun Agony summer pack, which means I think the rubber cat is now gone. And it's now limited. Pineapple Monkey, Obby World Egg minigame summer gifts and summer pack. Pretty good. And there's 5 new eggs, ranging from 1 to 10x, or roughly 1 to 10x, or whatever. Seashells, I think, is the prison keys, which means the global event bags are going to be coming back again for 2 more weeks. And 500 seashells for a random chance of a huge water blaster, surfboard, summer booth, and more. This is like similar to the glitched event on top of the prison event that we just had. That's interesting. And also costs 150,000 gems. That's actually a lot of gems. Tiki Egg Hunt at every turn instead of every 4 hours. Get a 100x chance. Oh my god. Every turn at 8 gives you a boss fight, which surely should be pretty good and not just be shit. Summer Party Pack gives you a chance of the Sun Agony and the Rich Cat and the Pineapple Monkey going to be also there. Summer Booth is very similar to the Pet Simulator X booth. Some of the pool actually looks pretty cool. Water Blaster, that's similar to Pet Simulator X thing they had going on. Rank 30, that's what I got, rank 30. And finally, we can change our clan description icon. Oh my god. And yeah, GG the Goop Clan, Free Clan, and Unity for achieving top 3. Even if Goop Clan is known for using super macros, that is so cringe. Summer decorations, that's pretty cool. It's very, yeah, it's similar to Pet Simulator X. Dumb Party's 4 times more. Prison keys are now tradable, which means if you want to use old accounts to do the prison key distribution, whatever, go for it. Change drop key to be less, which that's fair enough. Transfers for an extra month, so if you guys have any huges or exclusive for Pet Simulator X, you guys have got until July to get that gone. Auctions gain second 10, 15 seconds. I think there's a bug. Fix lucky box blocking other event areas from spawning. Events from spawning. Change shaman on the floor in the void world. Void chest for Oni again, of course. New player tutorial, flag and memory issues. Added automate, reload support for fishing and dig sites. And police hoverboard finally has sound. Don't forget sunscreen. Alright, let's turn on the music and got high fakes again for another hour. Ah, that's actually not bad. Anyway, let's get into the world. Shell Beach Island. This is actually interesting. So now I need to hatch 100 of these. That's actually easy. Balancing issues. You don't have to do the parkour. You can just walk through N9. And this gives you the huge and the other things, which includes the Sun Agony. Okay, interesting. And it also costs 10 times more than the normal egg at a return of 4. Which is interesting. But I do wonder how much it is going to take to get to these new pets in terms of damage. Oh, not damage, in terms of block. We need to do layout 2. And there is a obby to go further. Let us explore this possibility. Even if it is an obby world. Is this like a better chance of a better egg? Oh no. I need to get back. But it's called falling a fair amount. Oh wait, you can just use your hoverboard. But I wonder what the egg itself. That's a better chance the further you go along. But the parkour itself is actually kinda tricky. Oh no. Like you just you can just cheese it that way. And this one's the 2x. I think this one. No! Give me back. Take me back. Take me back. Take me back. Take me back. No. No. Take me back. Take me to Havana. Allow me to get on top of... Let me just see over here what the chances are. And it's another 2x chance. God damn it. But I suppose these have like a randomized chance. Over time? Oh. Oh. Try again. I need to try once more. Okay, never mind. Never mind. Fuck it. We're supposed to go to area 200. Need to go to earlier area because there's a egg hunt that we need to try out. Oh, it starts in 30 minutes. What? 30 minutes? What? Why did you need to make it 30 minutes? Man. That mildly infuriates me. But I suppose it gives us time with the parkour to see if there is a... an egg with a better chance. Because there is a better chance that people will be going towards it. And I can't even... I cannot even... Even with a hoverboard, it's not easy. Like, seriously, come on, man. At least make it a little bit easier. No, the stupid hoverboard sabotage me. Come on, man. But at least I'm getting some bars, at least. Which means I wouldn't be surprised if the maximum capacity is going to be like 20,000 for bars or something like that. And I don't think there's any shiny relics around because nobody realistically cares about them at all. Like, at all. Okay. Okay, this parkour really is not very easy at all. But there is a machine of it. How did I seriously fail that so easily? There is a machine that gives you a chance of a tier 8 enchance? Interesting. And then I fall off immediately. Like I'm somehow not surprised. Even when you're supposed to use your 2 feet that you have to get yourself all the way here. Buy a rare enchant for 35,000 gems and a T6. Actually, I'm going to try my hand at, this is gonna maybe sound like a dumb idea, but go. Yeah, it probably is possible to reach over there with a hoverboard. I just tried it, and I somehow got kind of close. Well, at least the areas around here are actually interactable, and you can actually go outside of the area. And it's also a 2x chance of a huge still. Another 2x. Like, I'm going to be seeing another chance apart from the 2x. Like, are we? Oh, I actually get a damage buff, like 5%. Interesting. And yeah, and also the thesis of like Titanic was actually clickbait, because we only have a huge in there as a chance to obtain. So what we need to do for the next half of an hour? I suppose have a bit of an exploration to see about perhaps a better huge egg to fall for a bit. Even if it sounds like I'm somehow losing my voice. Jesus. Speaking of Jesus, I fell off the map again. And then I somehow fell through that. Like, how is that even possible? And then I fell through again. Bruh. So get a party box that's worth 622 gems. Okay, just need to send knights and yeah. The word that I was trying to mention is careful, but no. We are not careful. I make a risk. And I fail miserably. And yeah, my alt accounts will be coming over to the final area after this video is recorded, because they are well, they're gonna be AFKing in the first area or the first area in the last update, because I can't be bothered to bring them across and nothing again. And yeah, just take me back. Just take me back. But I suppose you can do this just with your own feet. But like, what would you want to do with your own feet? Just kidding, I cannot jump for the life of me, because these are like different sizes. Like, this is not even easy to get across, because you keep falling off the map. Then it's impossible. Like, Preston, can you make the parkour easier? Because this is way too annoying for the casual player. Like, I don't do obbies every day. Advantage of the money potential that there is with these few eggs at this moment in time. And yeah, hopefully you guys did enjoy the video. If you did, leave a like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys tomorrow. Cheers!